Chag Purim Sameach. Is everybody ready to rock and roll? All right, we're going to get started right now with a little Purim music. Chag Purim, Chag Purim, Chag Gadol HaYeladim, Masechot Rashanim, Shoferet Yehudim, Havana Risha. Havana Risha, Barashanim, a little louder, Chag Purim,
Chag Purim,
Chag Gadol HaYehudim,
Masechot Rashanim,
Shoferet Yehudim, Havana Risha,
Havana Risha,
Havana Risha, Barashanim. Shana avo lehitareya, lai lai lai, la la, lai lai lai, lai lai lai, lai lai lai, la la, lai lai lai.
I give our Hazzanim a hand, everybody. All right. Woo! You ready for some fun? All right. I hope it did not get past anybody the internal joke about the rabbi being able to be his own minion. All right, just want to make sure you didn't. That was supposed to be a built-in part of this. Right, so so we're going to follow along with our Megillah reading. We're going to tell the story both from the traditional Megillah in the Hebrew and through a creative storytelling. You're going to be part of it. So you're going to have to watch the screen, because when it says all, you are all right? Are you all, Carrie? You are all going to respond. Now, those of you, how many of you have a grogger? Let me hear it. All right. So this sign is going to be very important. All right? This sign is going to be very, very important. When this sign is up that says stop, means there's no grogger action. But when we say the name of Haman, bow, 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 bow. All right, a little slow over there, but you'll catch you on there. All right, we're going to get started with the bracha, with the blessing, and all of our Megillah readers who are up here as well. Let's begin the Purim reading.
Baruch.
Amen.
Put the mic right to your chin.
Where does it start?
No, he's got the
right.
Fire heat and nail.
Where's it at?
Put the mic right in your chin.
Oh, okay. I got it. He'll read off the paper. What?
Vayahi bimei Achashverosh, hu, Achashverosh, Chamalech, Me'oru ve'arkush, Sheva, ve'estrimu me'ya, Medina, Bayamim, Hahem, Keshevet, HaMelech Achashverosh Al Kisei Malchuto Asher Beshushan Habira Bishnat Shalosh LeMalcho Asa Mishte LeChosara VeAvada Chel paras umatai apartamim visare hamadinot lefanav becharoto et osher kevod malchuto ve'et yekar tiferet Gedulato Yamim Ramim Shmonim Umeyat Yom.
A long time ago in Persia, in a city called Shushan, there lived a king of the name of Ahashverosh. The king had a wife named Vashti. One night, King Ahashverosh had a party in the palace. He ordered Queen Vashti to dance for his guests. Queen Vashti was a strong-minded woman who didn't take orders from anyone, even her husband, the king. She put her hands on her hips and said,
"Absolutely not."
That made the king very angry. He shook his finger at her and cried,
"How dare you ignore the wishes of the king? You are banished from my court."
And so Vashti was swept from the room with a swish of her dress. Over the next few weeks, King Ahashverosh became very lonely. He missed his queen. Although he would never admit it to anyone, he called for his advisor, Haman.
Boo!
Boo! Boo! And told him that he wanted to find a new wife. It was decided that there would be a beauty pageant and that the king would choose his bride from among the contestants. Word about the pageant spread throughout the land, and it came to the attention of a man named Mordechai.
Woo!
We like Mordechai.
Woo!
Who had a beautiful cousin named Hadassah.
Ish Yahudi Haya Beshushan Habira Ushmo Mordechai Ben Yahir Ben Shimi Ben Kishish Yemini Asher Hagla Mirushalayim Im Hagola Asher Hagleta Im Yachan Yach Melech Yehuda Asher Hegla Nebuchadnezzar Melech Bavel Vayechi Amen Et Hadassah Ki Esther Batodoki Em La Avaim Vehanarat Yefatar Vetovat Marech umot aficha ve'ima lekacha.
When Mordechai heard about this pageant, Mordechai, he had a brilliant idea.
If my cousin Hadassah enters the beauty pageant, perhaps she will win the eye of the king. After all, it couldn't hurt to have a friend in the palace.
And so it came to pass. Hadassah's name was changed to Esther in order to hide her identity. And she did indeed become queen, having won the beauty pageant. One day when Mordechai went to the palace to visit, he overheard two guards at the palace gate plotting to kill the king. He hurried to the palace and told Esther, who revealed the plot to the king, saving his very life. When the king heard about the loyalty of Mordechai, he ordered it to be written in the book of records, which we will come back to a little later.
בימים ההם, ומרדכי יושב בשער המלך, כתב בכתן ותחש, שני סריסי המלך, משומרי הסף, ויבקשו לשלוח יד, פעם מלך אחשוורוש, ויוודע הדבר למרדכי, ויגד לאסתר המלכה, ותאמר אסתר המלך בשם מרדכי, ויבוקש הדבר, וימצא, ויתלו שניהם על עץ, ויכתב בספר. דברי הימים לפני המלך.
Sometime after these things had happened, the king promoted Haman. Above all his other advisors, well, all the people in Shushan bowed down to Haman. Because they feared for their life. Mordechai said,
Jews do not bow down to anyone but God.
Haman. Decided it was not enough to punish only Mordechai, but also all the Jews of Persia. The Jews found themselves in great danger because of this one man who refused to bow down to the king's wicked advisor. Haman decided to cast lots, in Hebrew, Purim, in order to decide the day he would get rid of the Jews. So the Purim were cast, and the 13th of Adar was the day that was chosen. Then Haman told the king,
there is a group of people who do not obey the king's laws. If it pleases the king, let there be an edict issued for their destruction.
The king agreed. The edict was issued and distributed throughout the kingdom.
Vayomer Haman. La melech Ahasuerosh yeshno am echad mefuzar umforad bein hamim bechol medino malhutecha Vedatehem shono mikol'am Ve'edate ha-melech ein amosim Ve'la melech ein shoveh lechaniham Imo ha-melech tov yikatev le'avdam Va'asere alafim kikar kesef Eshkol al yaday osei hamlaha lechavi el ginzei hamelech.
Thereupon the king removed his signet ring from his hand and gave it to Haman, son of Hammedatah the Agagite, the foe of the Jews. And the king said, the money and the people are yours to do with it as you see fit. Meanwhile, back at the town gate, when Mordechai and all the Jews of Persia read the edict, they were very, very afraid. They refused to eat and cried all day long. Oy vey, oy vey, oy vey. What I want to know is how they knew Yiddish back in Persia time. The 13th of Adar was approaching fast. Mordechai told Esther that it was time. She told the king that if the Jewish people were to be destroyed, she would be included as well. Esther was very, very afraid to approach the king because she remembered what had happened to Queen Vashti.
Vayasar HaMelech et Tavato me'al yadoho vayitenda lehaman. Ben Hamedata Ha'agagi Tzorir Hayahudim Vayomer Hamelech Lechaman. Ha'kesef Natun La'ach V'ha'am La'sot Bo Katov Be'enech.
Meanwhile, when Mordechai... Oh,
yeah.
Chapter 4.
Vayomer Mordechai lechashiv el Esther al tedami v'nafshech lechimalet beit hamelech mikol hayehudim ki im haharesh Taharishi Ba'et hazot Reva ve'hatzelam Ya'amod la'yehudim Mimakom aher Ve'atu ve'et avit Tovedu Umi yodea Im le'ot kazot Higa'et le'molehut Va'tomer Esther Lechashiv el Mordechai.
Lech kinos et kol ha-Yehudim hanimseim b'shushan v'tsumu alai v'al tochlu v'al tishtu shiloshet yamim laila v'ayom gam ani v'narotai atsum kein v'chein avo el hamelech asher luchadat v'chasher avati avati v'yavor Mordechai v'yas k'chol asher tzivata alav Esther.
Swallowing her fear, Esther entered the king's chamber and said,
"Oh, king, I came to invite you to a special feast that I have prepared for you and Haman."
The king said,
"Anything you wish, anything you desire, even half my kingdom is yours."
The feast was smashing success, King Ah. They roast again offered Queen Esther anything she desired. She said,
"How about another feast tomorrow? And be sure to bring
The king ordered it so. The next morning, Haman! Passed by the palace gate. Mordechai did not bow down again. Haman! Became very angry. He complained to his family and friends. After all, he was a man honored by the king and even invited to another feast by the queen for that very evening. Yet all he could think about was Mordechai the Jew. Bah, humbug, who would not bow down to him. Haman! The tall gallows be built to hang Mordechai.
Vayetze Haman. Bayom hahu sameach vetov lev vehirot Haman. Et Mordechai v'shar ha-melech v'lo kam v'lo zam imenu v'yam aleh ha-man. Al Mordechai heima v'yitapak ha-man. Vayavo el beito bigishlach Vayave et ohavav Ve'et zeresh ishto Bayisaper lahem Haman. Et kevod ashro Berov benov ve'et kol asher gidlo ha-melech ve'et asher niso al ha-sarim ve'avdei ha-melech.
The night after the first feast, the king could not sleep. So he decided to look through the old record books instead of counting sheep. When reading, he found the story about Mordechai had saved him from being killed. The king wondered, what has been done to honor this great, great man, Mordechai? He asked his advisors, and they told him,
"Nothing has been done, sire."
At that very moment, Haman was arriving to inform the king of his plans to hang Mordechai. The king summoned Haman. And told him he wanted to reward a very loyal subject.
The wicked advisor thought the king was talking about him, so he suggested a lavish reward of gold and diamonds in the honor of riding the king's favorite horses through the city of the streets, and the king cried,
"Perfect! What a great idea!
And then declared that it would be Mordechai who would thus be rewarded. So Haman turned purple with rage, and he thought,
"Could it be that this man who refused to bow down to me would now be honored throughout Shushan?"
And then, to make matters worse, King Ahasuerus ordered Haman to lead Mordechai through the center of the city, riding the king's favorite Seuss or horse.
Vayomer Hamelech Ahasuerush, Vayomer Lester Amalka, Muse Fezehu, Asher Maoli Bola Sotken, Vatomer Esther, Ish Tar Vilyev, Haman. Vehaman. Nivad milivne amelech vehamalka vehamelech kam bechamoto mimishre ayayin el ginat habitan vehaman. Amad levakesh al nafsho me'ester hamalka ki ra'a ki chalta elav hara me'et ha'melech.
Afterwards, Haman Bovel again complained to his family and friends, but it was time for the guards to escort him to the palace for the second feast. At the feast, the king once again offered the queen anything she desired. She spoke up bravely to her husband, telling him of this terrible news that someone was threatening to kill her people. Boo! King Ahasuerus was outraged to hear about a plot against his loyal subject, Mordechai. To mention his beloved bride, he called Haman to his side and said,
"You must do something about this terrible thing I have just heard."
The king urged his wife to repeat her news. Esther looked straight at Haman. Summoning all her strength, said,
"You wicked, evil man! I told the king about your plan to destroy the Jews, including me!"
Mordechai yatza milifne hamelech levush machut tehelet vahor vahateret sa'am gedola v'tachrich buz v'argaman v'hayir shushan sa'am v'zomeha Layahudim, Haita Ora, Vesimcha, Vesoson, Vikor. Uho Medina, Umedina, Uho Yirvayir, Mekom Asher, Vidarha Melevirato, Magia. Simcha, Vesoson, Layahudim. Mishtar vayom tov v'rabin me'amei ha'eretz nid yahadim kinefal pahad ha'yudim aleihem.
The king yelled at Haman. sends him to be hung on the very gallows he had built for Mordechai.
Yay!
And that was the end of the wicked Haman.
Vayich tov Mordechai et ha-devarim ha-ele Vayishlach sforim el kol ha-yehudim Asher v'chol medinot Ha-melech achashverosh ha-karovim v'har-chochim Lekayem Alehem Liot Osim Et Yom Arba'a Asar Lechodesh Adar Ve'et Yom Hamisha Asar Bo Bechoshana Veshana Kayahim Asher Nahu Behem Hayahudi Leoi Vehem V'ha-chodesh asher nepach lahem miyagom l'simcha me'evel le'yom tov la'asot otam yemei mishem v'simcha
And on that very day, the Jews of Persia defended themselves and were victorious. They were grateful for having been saved, and there was light and joy, gladness and honor. So now on the holiday of Purim, we tell this story, we dance and sing. We give money to the poor, matzahot yalev yonim, and send gifts to our friends, mishloach manot. And no matter how much other people have tried to plot and scheme, the Jewish people continue to live and help fulfill God's dream. Let us join together singing with Hazzan Mimi, a wicked, wicked man.
And Cantor's child, right? Somewhere? Joining us on stage. Oh, once there was a wicked, wicked man, and Haman was his name. Oh, who lied about the Jews, so they were not to blame.
Oh, today we'll marry, marry me. Oh, today we'll marry, marry me. Oh, today we'll marry, marry me. And not some home in Tashin.
Esther was the lovely queen of King Ahasuerus.
Oh, today we'll marry, marry me. Oh, today we'll marry, marry me. Oh, today we'll marry, marry me. And not some home in Tashin.
Esther had a cousin and his name was Mordechai. Woo! He asked her, can you help us? And she said, of course I'll try.
Oh, today we'll marry, marry me. Oh, today we'll marry, marry me. Oh, today we'll marry, marry me. And not some moment
when Esther speaking to the king of Haman's name
mentioned,
aha, said he, oh no, he won't, I'll spoil his bad intention.
Oh, today we'll marry, marry me. Oh, today we'll marry, marry me. Oh, today we'll marry, marry me and not some woman tasher.
In spite of Haman's awful plan and the scare he gave, Esther was so good and kind, she knew just how to say.
One more time!
Oh, today we'll marry, marry me. Oh, today we'll marry, marry me. Oh, today we'll marry, marry me.
Unfortunately, as we all know, there is still a world ripe with anti-Semitism. There are still those who wish to hurt us and destroy us. For all of our teen community, if you have not yet met Michelle, hopefully you have. Michelle, stand up and wave. Michelle Greenberg has put together a really meaningful and wonderful program, an important program for all of our teens and our parents. The next one taking place on anti-Semitism, a panel discussion about where kids unfortunately see it today in high schools and on college campuses. It is taking place on March 22nd, March 22nd. So join us here that evening. As soon as the incredible Mordechai Superstar, which is going to be taking place in just a moment, takes place here on this stage, afterwards we invite everybody for dessert and drink into the chapel. And then at 8 o'clock, for those who missed the early Maariv service, there will be another Maariv service and a full Megillah reading for those who are interested. Now, without further ado... Hazzan Stein!
Ladies and gentlemen, Temple Aliyah and Shomre Torah Synagogue present for your Purim enjoyment, Mordechai Superstar!
The Shpiel's the thing today. It's not a play from 71. This is just a lot more fun. Things have changed. It's not about you know who.
Let's go.
don't think I have a future. In fact, I might just lose my head. Save tomorrow for tomorrow. Think about today instead.
What's the deal? Tell me what's happening. What's the spiel? Tell me what's happening. Fish the meal. Tell me what's happening. Let's get real. Tell me what's happening. When do we dance all the night away? When do we eat all the room and all? When do we drink until we pass out? When do we party till they kick us out?
Why should you want to know? I can give you facts and figures. There's one thing I'm not doing. Dance for this crowd and just a thought.
Tell me what's happening, what's the spiel? Tell me what's happening, pitch the meal. Tell me what's happening, let's get real. Tell me what's happening,
when you dance and sex in this outfit. Let me dance and sex in this outfit.
When do we drink until we pass out? When do we party until we kick us out?
Steve, that's no good. Why you disobey my order? Don't do what it is I need. You should do just like you order. Now your end is my decree.
She got dumped, that's what's happening. She got dumped, that's what's happening. She got dumped, that's what's happening. Her head's lost, that's what's happening. She got dumped, that's what's happening. She got dumped, that's what's happening. She got tossed, that's what's happening. Her head's lost, that's what's happening.
If he thinks you're Jewish, boy, he's clueless.
Everything's all right, yes, everything's fine.
And it's cool that he thinks you're sweet. He's on fire for your head and feet. Close your eyes, and relax. You'll be queen by tonight. Bat your eyes, he's mesmerized. You'll be queen, that's right.
Yeah. What do you do about King Ahasuerus, inept and unwise? Hero of fools.
No sense, no passion, no brains, no sechel.
All of these people, they are his.
I see Mictan and Teresh. They'll heal a king now. I know the plan. I smell a glimmer of glory. I'll tell the king and you'll be my man.
We'll kill the king, yeah. That is our plan, our plan, our plan, yeah.
He'll tell the king, he'll be my man.
We got a plan. I'll kill the king, yeah, perfect devices. Back when a king is out of his class.
But when do we kill him? His power increases by leaps every minute. Let's dump his.
I see big time and terrish. They'll kill the king now. I know their plan. I taste a glimmer of glory. I'll tell the king and he'll be my man.
We'll kill the king, yeah. our plan, yeah, that is our plan.
I'll tell the king, yeah, he'll be my man.
We got a plan. We'll sneak in.
I gotta.
Now you've heard the news. Bigton and Teresh are fools. They pretend to dance and sing. They can't even kill the king. Morty knows their little scheme. He'll use it later on.
You're divine, and I should genuflect. But I bow to the one God I love and I respect. Isn't it a pity on this you do rely? Perhaps you would be liked if you were half a decent guy.
So you are the worst, I think. Sign a decree, old-fashioned murder spree. Come on, King Ahi. Hey, so bake a boy. Here's your cream cheese and lox. First I'll slice your bagel in half. Should the Farsi line go here? That'll get a laugh.
Thank you.
quiet. Little Morty is a riot. These common folk, they are a joke.
Tell the Jews they should bow down, not shake their lulavs all around. They are the waste. They are a curse.
Crowd. One thing we can do to stop this shouting: if all the Jews were killed, the noise would cease at last, and there'd be no one left to sing this toiling song.
How will things turn out now?
I've been koshering my kitchen, making sure the forest pots are clean and not tamei. Then I thought about it. Why do all this stuff? Could we just be vegan?
Could we just be vegan?
I've been hearing you fudging. This and that hurts so much, I think you're getting old. Then I thought about what Yiddishkeit means to you. Okay, you can be vegan.
Could we just be vegan?
No milk, no meat, no fuss now. But without a strong eating, it would not feel like us. We are made of something stronger than all that. So could we have some chicken?
I've been raised on tradition. Cousin Morty, you're the standard for our faith. I look up to you as a model Jew. So could you stop your kvetching?
Boy, we're really wretched.
I am sorry for doubting. It's just that being Jewish makes them hate us even more. That's why I've been fasting and tearing up my clothes. Could I get a button?
Could I get a button?
Or a safety pin?
I think we've reached that point now.
Carnivores, as long as we are Jewish.
Would we all be Jewish?
Not for everyone, it's screwish.
Could we all be Jewish?
A massive change. He'll think it's odd that there's just one God, and that he's one that's mine. I don't know how he'll take this. Will he divorce or take a Oy vey, a man. And a man can be a bit dense, you see, but I know he'll understand. He's just a man.
I like the color blue. I wear a size 7 shoe. I like the color white too. Bagels and lox are my go-to. Yes, I'm a Jew.
Hold on a moment. I'm sorry, guys, but there is a tradition here at Shomrei Torah Synagogue that we have, well, I'll tell you. Here, our youth take care of this. Come here, guys. Yeah, don't be shy. Tell us what's going on, because they don't know. They don't know a thing. What's
going
on?
In order to save the Jews, we need to raise at least $613 to go towards Shabbat angels. Shabbat Angels is an organization started by two LA women in their 20s that donate money, delivers groceries, and provides companionship to Holocaust survivors and Jewish families in need. You can scan the Venmo code right there. To donate or give cash to any of the teens who are walking around with a bucket. They're also walking. Yeah, yes. They're walking around with the codes. And also, if you're using Venmo, please make sure to put Purim donation in the caption. Please help the youth department reach our goal.
All right, everybody. So,
$613.
Yeah. So get out that Venmo. Let's see your phones. Give money to those who are coming out there, and I'll tell you why it's very important. If we allow Haman, if we allow him to live, then the Jews would be no more. So we're counting on you. Just $613. Come on.
All right, she's my husband, so I got $20 for that.
Okay. All right. Okay, everybody. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Don't forget. Very important. Here we go. Come on.
Plowshares evermore. Show me there's a reason for you not wanting me to die. Not so sure where, why. Not so high on why. All right. But you survive.
Let's hear it for Hazzan Stein! Unbelievable, and our amazing, amazing, amazing actors and actresses. Way to go! Chag Purim Sameach! So there is food and fun drinks in the chapel, and there's going to be a full Megillah reading with Mariv at 8 o'clock. What an amazing, amazing opportunity for all of us, Temple Aliyah, Shomrei Torah Synagogue, to be together as Kehillah Echad, as one community this evening. Enjoy our Purim tomorrow morning, 8 a.m. in the chapel here for Minyan and a full Megillah reading. Join us for so many more things together. A second night Seder. An amazing job by Hazzan Mimi and the amazing, amazing kids.
And the youth department has raised over $1,000.
Over $1,000 from all of you. Thank you so much.
All Shpielers, come back to the stage for a group photo. All Shpielers, come back to the stage for a group photo.
Someone take a photo.
Dessert and drinks in the chapel.
Haley Silvers, where are you? Where are you, Haley Silvers? Haley's coming, Haley's coming, Haley's coming.